Hello, everyone, and welcome to the show. Thank you so much for tuning in. So I've got an amazing guest in the house today. She's a fantastic singer, songwriter, instrumentalist, and composer, and she is the first female flutist in Nigeria. I have here with me Ebele. Hello, Ebele. How are you?
I'm good.
Welcome to EL Now.
Thank you.
Okay, so your brand name is Ebele. You're known as Ebele the flutist.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
But your full name is Ebele Iziamakam.
Wow. Very correct.
I've been practicing. Okay. Yeah. So before we get into your craft, you brought your flute today. I'm so excited, but we'll get to that in just a second. We want to find out more about you and how you got started in music. So tell us a little bit about your background, where you were born and where you grew up.
I'm from Anambra State, but I grew up in Benin, precisely Edo State, Benin precisely. I did my primary secondary school there in Benin, but my high institution I did in Enugu. Quite a long journey for me. But I started the flute quite early, age 14. And the flute was like a hobby, something I just like to play and do just a hobby thing. I was exposed to a musical background where I have a lot of people, the white people that comes to train us on music. We train it as just learning the flute. I sing very well then, and I needed the flute just to accompany me. I can say I was inspired by a Philippines lady. She was the only flutist among the white people that came to train us in that school. So I loved, I fell in love with her.
What school is this, like in secondary school?
Not in secondary school, okay. Just a musical
a
school.
A music school, okay.
I was in secondary school at
okay.
that time.
Okay.
And sometimes I had to sneak out when I'm supposed to go for extramural classes and just to go and learn the flute and train because of my, I love the flute, I love to learn music. So she inspired me a lot at that age. I had issues then with my dad, especially because he wanted me to just face my studies and nothing else to bother me. But that's why I said I sneak out. Go and learn. Yeah.
Okay. Why the flute?
Yeah.
What was it about the flute that?
Yes, that's a very good question because though she was the only person that was playing the flute at that school then, the Philippines lady that was training me on flute. But I can say I have a very high-pitched voice. When I used to sing in the choir, my voice used to be one of the highest. And I disturbed even at home then. At home, I'm singing. When I'm in the kitchen, everywhere I'm singing, you can hear my voice from this time. I'm singing high. So the flute is a very high-pitched instrument. I just feel it complements my voice kind of. When you play it very well, you can tell what I'm saying. I mean, so even so, I didn't care the complexities.
So tell us what kind of child you were. Were you a troublemaker? Were you like a straight-A student, you know? Tell us a little bit about that.
I would say the part of, you know, sneaking out to go and learn the instrument was another part that was very funny by my parents. And I can say I'm a passionate person and I'm very goal-oriented. I mean, when I set my mind to do anything, I don't care. Nobody stops me. I think that part of me is still with me. It still flows around with me in everything I do now, even as a lady now. It's still part of me. The funny part of it is they never really knew how much I've really gone into this thing. Do they know how I learn, how I go to the training? Till one of the days we were having exams, okay. And our parents were called. So come and watch your children. I mean, some of them are playing fantastically well, they play instruments. And my parents were called and my dad was watching me. I didn't even have a flute of my own. I was using the Philippines lady's flute to learn. So he came and saw me play a full Mozart. You know, I stood in the midst of the congregation and I played a whole full piece from the beginning to the end.
Wow.
I mean, my father was like, Jesus Christ. I mean, he has to order a flute for me. That was my first flute. I actually had my first flute at age 14.
Okay.
And
after he had seen you play?
After he had seen me play. So it's a striking point for me. That's why I always say, I tell media I started by age 14. And it has never left me since then. I mean, he was so amazed by what he saw that they couldn't believe his eyes, you know. Especially the fact that I played it very well. That's not a challenge again because they didn't even allow me to study music in university. I read accounting.
Okay.
And I also read business admin as my postgraduate course. My mother said no, she wants to see me wear the suits, you know. They like all these bankers when they say they want me to be a banker. It's funny, you know, what parents can do. Yeah. And now the funny thing is that this is what I'm doing right now. Mm-hmm. I had to leave all those accounting things and it's still the music. It's still my passion, yeah.
Coming up next on EO Now.
You find people playing the flute in Muson, like a classical environment where you have an orchestra.
Okay.
That's because people never see the flute as an instrument you can use soul-handedly on his own. Mm. They always feel it's an instrument you can use in an enclosure.
Okay.
Where you have other instruments, like a classical movement.
I've never held a flute. I've never played a flute.
Okay.
So what are the different parts of the flute?
Okay, the thing about the flute is it's a complex instrument, okay. First of all. You know, you have sax everywhere. You have a lot of people. Mm-hmm. The sax is very more common.
Yeah.
And like Mike Karimo, I featured him on my first song, really. He plays one of my best person that plays the sax very well. Mm-hmm. I know he used to tell me that I should come and teach him how to play the flute. I was fortunate to be in a show with T-Mac.
Okay.
T-Mac, and we played together. And T-Mac talked so much about the flute. I was happy because a lot of people had to learn so much about the flute. You find people playing the flute in Muson, like a classical environment where you have an orchestra.
Okay.
That's because people never see the flute as an instrument you can use soul-handedly on his own.
Mm.
They always feel it's an instrument you can use in an enclosure.
Okay.
Where you have other instruments, like a classical movement. Mm. So you never see people play it out, do it. On the professional basis, like everyone,
yeah, like a solo.
Yeah,
like
a solo, no.
Okay.
And then, and again, because it's complex, it can be so simple, but it's very complex, even more complex than the sax. I'm trying to make Nigerians, this part of the world, to know that it's not just an instrument you can use. And T-Mac said it that day on the lecture. You don't think the flute is just an instrument you can use just within. It can actually be used for anything, mm-hmm. just like the sax is being used for everything.
Okay.
So, but it's not acceptable here in Nigeria.
Yeah.
This part of this world, they said, no. It's not, this is not, the flute is just for Western.
Right.
They use it for classical music, mm-hmm. no. But some of my songs, I play jazz, have played classic, and this last one is even an urban song. So, yeah. Yeah. I've actually you know, defeated that mindset of, and I'm making people now get acquainted to the flute. A lot of people are interested in the flute right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they want to know much about the flute. So that's the complexities of the flute. So you can actually use it with pure learning to do different kinds of songs.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, I just want a quick sample.
Okay, maybe
just
like
an example.
A freestyle.
A freestyle, yes, please.
Okay. Give me one of this kind of beats,
like
beat
a beat. Yeah, no, I wish we had some music here. Like drop a beat.
Those kind of beats, like Divan.
Yeah.
That's the time you want to hear.
Right, and just like flow along with it. No, but that was beautiful. That
Thank
was beautiful.
You.
Sometimes I feel so down.
You sing really well. You have quite a few songs out. You did a song with Cobams called Dreams Come True, where you actually did a bit more singing than playing of the flute. Tell us about that track and working with Cobams.
Yeah, it was fantastic because working with Cobams was interesting. I think it was Cobams' idea, really.
Mm.
And I really appreciated it because I never really wanted to do anything that won't emphasize on my flute more. So, but Cobams told me, there's so much about you. You have to show your versatility for people to know. Don't retreat yourself to just I can play the flute alone. Mm. So he encouraged me to do something different.
Okay.
In short, the parts that I even played, I played the flute in the intro of the song. I had to even beg him to play the flute there. He just wanted me to just sing. But I couldn't just do without not playing my flute in any track. So, and I'm starting a training on music right now.
Okay.
I've started giving out music flute tips online already.
Okay.
When people go to my fan page, Ebele the Flutist fan page, they can find those that love the flutes and they want to learn.
Mm-hmm. Well, awesome. We'll definitely be looking forward to all the other things that you'll be unveiling very soon. But we have to go. But thank you so much for stopping by and joining us on the show. So before we let you go, can you give us another little something?
Do you have a specific song? Just want me to play this song.
I just like hearing you play.
Or should I play the national anthem, which is more?
Oh, sure. Very patriotic. Yes, let's do that. Let's do that. Thank you so much. That was awesome.
Thank you.
I'm going to start taking flute lessons. Okay. All right, guys. That's all the time we have on the show today. Thank you so much for watching. But do go out there. Have a great weekend. And I'll see you guys next week. Bye.